Gosh, you're never going to retire, are you, Ian?
I know.
The Matterhorn of Norway.
I'll leave you this.
There it is.
House of Norway.
I can't see all you can get so nice pictures through the windows.
Okay, this is the beginning of the Trollstigen. And again, the mountains are so high, you can see there's a car down here. But there isn't any way to get it all in one shot. Just impossible. Solid rock face, 3,000 or 4,000 feet high. Okay, this is a picture of the Trollstigen car wash. Yeah. Look at that. Bridge we're going to cross. Back. Valley. Here's the bridge. The rainbow on the other side. Yeah. To some extent. Oh, you keep going by it and by it? Yes. At the very top of the Trollstigen, and you can see there's a lot of snow on the mountains still in this area. And we're going to go over here. And we'll see where the falls drop right off. It's basically where these people are, where the falls drop off. Now they're getting a good picture of the snowfields. Is Martha in the snow? And throw a snowball? You see all the snow right here. We're right in it at this point. It's quite a hike down the stairs just to get down to the viewing area.
He ate too many shoes.
There we go. Got a very good view of the falls from here. The bridge way down here that we crossed, and all the hairpin turns. Hard to believe, but people have been skiing up in here. You see the place they've been hiking up, and you can actually see the tracks coming down here. See the sun glistening off the tracks. You can see the warning here. Obviously they don't want anybody parachuting. Trollstigen. This is Trollstigen Highway. But there's lots of patches from lots of countries that were put on that sign. Oh, I see him. There are people skiing up here. Well, I didn't think I'd get a picture of anybody skiing down here, but I am.
Can you see them?
Sure can. I'm skiing very slow.
Yeah. Can you see
them? Yep. Now they're almost.
Oh, yeah. How did they get up?
Oh, you can see the footprints where they've marked, where they climbed up.
Over here?
Over on the right.
Yeah. Three of them. Yeah. There's a dog there, yes.
Huh?
A dog?
Yes.
Ah.
My goodness.
Is it the two foot there? It's not like a dog.
Can you see a dog, John?
There's three skiers here and a dog, believe it or not. Three skiers and a dog.
Almost to the shadow of the...
Way on the side. And that dog or whatever is following him. I don't know if it's a dog. I think it might be...
A reindeer?
No, I think it might be a sled he's pulling. Here they go. Oh, you can see him very well. That first ski you can see very well.
I think we better get going because there is another viewpoint on the before we get downhill again.
I think we maybe take downhill
now. Yeah, we can see those skiers. Way in the middle of the picture. Guess what time?
It must be later.
Between 11 and...
I don't think it's in danger. You think it's dangerous with Evelyn?
People everywhere.
Oh, there's skiing right here.
No, no skiing.
Yeah, I'm videoing one.
Oh, yeah, I see.
Walking up the hill.
Yeah, he's just taking a small... Yeah.
The other side of Trollstigen.
Yeah. I don't think it takes some time.
Glittering water. Look at the jungle. Glittering.
Yeah.
Two waters. Couple more.
Hey, don't start on cross the road.
It's hot. Must be very hot.
Oh, and that wall. Oh. Have to be careful of other people.
That's going to be so bad.
There's another rapid that we're going to... take a picture of. And we just made one quick stop. Well, we'll get a picture of this gorge. It's quite spectacular. On the way to Geiranger. And there are two ferries across here, so there's not as much waiting. They both leave at the same time. you.
Oh.
Oh Lord, that's worse.
Yes, our first view of the Geiranger fjord. And kind of at the other end of it from the town of Geiranger. Not sure what town this is right here. But we're going down. Geiranger, down at the docks, actually. And you get some idea what the size these cruise ships are. This huge ship, way up here at the end of the fjord. There's a sightseeing boat here. One of the waterfalls. View of Geiranger from Trollstigen. See, the cruise ship looks pretty small from here. And there's the Union Hotel down here. Little cabin we're staying in tonight, and it really isn't, again, a real picturesque area. You see the snow on top of the mountain. You can get over this way. Oops. You can see the lake right here. And mountains, it's almost 9 o'clock right now. And you see the light out in the middle of a field here. And so the sun is getting close to setting. And it gives you a little settlement across the lake from us. And in the foreground is a farm, and that's what the people that run the cabins have the farm here. The Viking ship here that's being repaired. This is at the cabins that we stayed at. This is described it here. It's all in Norwegian, but you can see the ship is being restored. It's right here. It's dark to see, but you get inside, you'll be able to see it pretty good. And you can see it's quite long, and the top boards and some of the ribs are new, and some of them look like they may be original. There's quite a shipbuilding industry here at this lake. You see them making a chair like Jens has on his porch in his mountain cabin. And somebody is good at woodworking. The board and it's burnt with what looks like the village here. And then if we just look at this ship one more time, we can we look at the inside, and we look at the keel. You see how the keel is constructed here. It's the new part of the keel. It's the old part back here. Now this is another ship with the same fellow had built, and this is showing the construction of it. It looks like this is, well, this is another ship, I guess, Jens, in the drawing. It's three-masted. That must be another ship.
No, that's another ship.
Yeah. Sure. And we'll show you a shot of this one. And this is a particular type of Viking sailing ship that made in this area. It's a bit unusual, the construction of it, actually. Now this one's quite well finished. And show you the keel underneath and the rigging. And where we are is Bjorkadal. And this is the story of the boat and the man's name who reconstructed the boat is here. You see, it took 7 to 8 years of his hobby to reconstruct this boat. This is a history of Viking ships. Okay, you're going to take the ferry from Lota to Anda right now. Wait, a Fjordland, which is the Glacier Museum. That's way down in this area. Lota Ferry? Am I just leaving the ferry landing? And there is one glacier across from this ferry landing. Yeah, a fairly good view of it over here. That's the end of the glacier. On our way to the Glacier Museum. Beautiful scenery everywhere. A little bit of the glacier on top of this mountain here. It's the edge of the glacier.
Stretch.
The road leading up to the first glacier, and what we're going to see is Trollstigen Glacier. This is just the end of it. We're just about ready to go into the first tunnel into the glacier. This is the very edge of the glacier here. Okay, we just came out of a 6.4 kilometer tunnel on the other side of the glacier. And you can see the edge of the glacier against the sky here. Really something. It's amazing. It doesn't come close to the road here, but it is down to this level. This is probably 1,000 feet high here. Very unusual. Okay, we're in Geiranger, and we're going to go into the Glacier Museum here. This is the Glacier Museum. Here's right over here. In fact, you can see the end of the glacier down here.